Hello dear students, good morning. Today we are going to study about the diode. Diode is the electronic device which have anode and cathode. Diode have various applications in electronics. Diode is a two terminal electronic device that conduct current in one direction only. Diodes are generally made from semiconductor, mostly silicon, but sometimes we also use the germanium. At absolute zero temperature, silicon and germanium acts as perfect insulator. So here we need to make the silicon and germanium as a conductor at zero temperature. We add some impurity. So that's why these semiconductors are called as extrinsic semiconductors. So here we study about the germanium and silicon structure. So inside the silicon, the atomic structure of silicon is 14. That means silicon have 14 protons. So silicon atom has 14 electrons. That means 2 electron in first orbit and 8 electron in second orbit and 4 electron in the outermost orbit. And germanium atomic number is 32. That means 32 protons, and germanium has 32 electrons. So that we understand this why, like 2 electron in first orbit and 8 electron in second orbit and 18 electron in third orbit and 4 electron in the outermost orbit. So that we can say that silicon and germanium are the tetravalent atom. It means that at outermost orbit they have 4 electrons. Silicon structure. So here silicon, here this is the silicon structure. We know the silicon have 4 electron at the outermost shell. So here the silicon 4 electron which has to share the covalent bond with its neighboring atom. So how we understand this, like this is silicon atom, right? And this silicon atom have 4 electron in outermost shell. So here one silicon atom make one silicon atom electrons make the covalent bond with neighboring silicon atom. So we can understand from this structure, right? So this is silicon structure. This structure have 4 electron at outermost shell. So one electron make with this one covalent bond with neighboring this one silicon atom, and second one make with this electron, and third one this, and fourth one this. So it means that here one silicon atom make the 4 covalent bond with neighboring silicon atom, right? So we can understand this. So this is the covalent bond, and these are the valence electron, and this is silicon atom. So I think so this is our structure is very clear. So now we will understand about the extrinsic intrinsic semiconductor. So intrinsic semiconductor are always in extremely pure form, means that they are not the mixed form. So it is also known as the undoped semiconductor. It shows a low electrical conductivity at low temperature. So we already know that such type of material are silicon and germanium. And extrinsic semiconductor are made when small amount of chemical impurity is added to intrinsic semiconductor. The doping of semiconductor increase its conductivity. The process to add impurity is known as the doping, and impurity atom called as dopants. So we know our intrinsic semiconductor are silicon and germanium because they are in pure form. At zero temperature they do not show the conductivity, right? So we need to create the conductivity at zero temperature so that we add some impurity inside the silicon and germanium. So how we create that? We add some impurity. like arsenic and boron, right? So these are the pentavalent or maybe trivalent. So that's why these semiconductors are called as extrinsic semiconductor. So here our extrinsic semiconductor have very most important application in our semiconductor devices, right? So means say extrinsic semiconductor play main roles. So types of dopants means which type of dopants we will use to create the extrinsic semiconductor. So here two types of dopants are possible: pentavalent atom and trivalent atom. So pentavalent atoms means that atoms have 5 valence electron in outermost shell, outermost orbit, such as arsenic, phosphorus, antimony, and lead. And if we think about the trivalent atoms, trivalent atoms have 3 valence electron in outermost shell, such as indium, aluminium, and boron. These dopants have similar sized atom as the pure semiconductor. That's why we can mix easily inside our intrinsic semiconductor in silicon and germanium. These dopants create two types of semiconductor: n-type semiconductor and p-type semiconductor. Let's you understand about the how we create n-type semiconductor and p-type semiconductor. So n-type and p-type semiconductor are extrinsic semiconductor. Then we understand about the n-type semiconductor. Inside the n-type semiconductor, we mix the pentavalent impurity inside the silicon. So it means that pentavalent impurity have 5 electron, and silicon one atoms have 4 valence electron in outermost shell. Then 4 electron of pentavalent atom makes a bond with neighboring silicon atom, while the fifth one is weakly bond. So it turned as n-type electron. Means fifth one electron are weakly bond, so that this impurity providing a one extra electron to move inside the semiconductor. So this electron is shown by this arrow. So the donor impurity contributes free electron. It means that we are adding one impurity, and impurity is giving a one extra electron to us. So such type of semiconductor is called as n-type semiconductor. Similarly, if we add a trivalent impurity inside the silicon atom, right, then what happen? The dopant atom like boron is a trivalent impurity, has less electron than the surrounding atom of silicon or germanium. Then the hole or vacancy is generated in trivalent atom. So it turned as p type of semiconductor, right? So here these are the silicon atom, and we mix with boron is a trivalent impurity. Trivalent means that it have only 3 electron in outermost shell. It means that one electron create the hole inside the extrinsic semiconductor. So the such type of silicon atom or such type of extrinsic semiconductor is called as p-type semiconductor, right? And further we will study about the p-n junction diode, right? So here, what is p-n junction diode? So p-n junction is the boundary between two types of semiconductor material like p-type and n-type semiconductor. So how we make this? We add the p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor in one container, right, in one smooth chamber like this. So here we mix a p-type impurity, p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor. So this side is the p-type material, and this side is n-type semiconductor material. So these here n-type have free electron, means one free electron, that's why marked by red colored, right? So So these are the free electrons, and these are the holes, these NPT holes, that's why we call as p-type material, right? So here the motion of electron and hole will create here depletion layer. So this region is called as depletion region. So what happen inside this means these electron will move in towards the hole and hole towards the electron. That's why this region. So here in mid of the p-type and n-type material, one layer will create. This layer will called as depletion region. So our p-n junction diode have two type of biasing, p-type biasing, no, forward biasing and reverse biasing. So first we understand about the forward biasing. Inside the forward biasing, what we do, p-type semiconductor side is connected by positive and n-type is connected by the negative. So what happening this, so our positive our negative sign and our n-type electron will reflect each other, right? If this is connected with n-type semiconductor, then these minus sign electron have already minus charge, and this minus sign again coming, it means that they are reflecting the electron. And here positive charge have already positive, and holes also have positive charge, is it means that they reflect the hole. So here what happening, so here happening is that, so here electron will move in towards the p side electron, and here hole will coming towards the n type of electron. Means that our so here one depletion layer will created. So how this will create, means electron will accommodate the hole place, and here the hole will accommodate the electron place. So that's why here one depletion layer will created. So battery induced electric fields. So first of what is the mechanism, so we can understand from these numbers. So here battery induced the electric field in direction of p to n type, right? So it means that p to n type, right? And the built-in electric field in the inside the direction of n to p, while the conventional current is flowing from p to n type, and the electron current is flowing from n to p type semiconductor, right? So is it clear our forward biasing? If our positive terminal is connected to p type semiconductor and n type semiconductor is connected by our negative of the battery, then this is called as the forward biasing. So and why we are calling as forward biasing, because here current is flowing very easily. So right, our forward biasing is clear, and further we will study about the reverse biasing. Inside reverse biasing, what happening here, our positive terminal is connected to negative and negative terminal is connected to positive. So what happening, our electron positive, we know the positive will reflect each other and negative positive will attract each other. Then what happening, so here happening is that electron will attract by positive and negative attract by the positive attract by the negative. So that here very small depletion layer will create. It means that our current is not flowing. It means that here electron not transferring to p-type and our hole is not moving towards the n-type. So that what happening here, battery induced electric field here and built in electric field only, but electron movement is not possible, right? So if our positive terminal is connected to n-type semiconductor and our positive terminal is connected to n-type terminal, and पॉजिटिव टू एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर एंड नेगेटिव टू द पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर. सो सच टाइप ऑफ बायसिंग इज कॉल्ड एज द रिवर्स बायसिंग. फर्दर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द वीआई कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कर्व. सो वीआई कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कर्व इज दैट. सो हियर वी प्लॉट द करंट वर्सेस वोल्टेज प्लॉट. सो वी नो द डायोड राइट रिवर्स बायस एंड फॉरवर्ड बायस. इफ वी इंक्रीज द वोल्टेज देन अवर करंट विल इंक्रीज. इफ वी इंक्रीज द बैटरी वोल्टेज देन अवर करंट विल इंक्रीज इन साइड द डायोड. सो विच इज द फॉरवर्ड बायसिंग रीजन. सो दिस रीजन इज द फॉरवर्ड बायसिंग रीजन एंड दिस वोल्टेज इज कॉल्ड एज द फॉरवर्ड बायस वेयर द अवर करंट इज इंक्रीजिंग. सो सिमिलरली इफ वी डिक्रीज द वोल्टेज सो व्हाट हैपनिंग देन अवर करंट इज सडनली ब्रेक डाउन द वोल्टेज राइट. सो दिस इज द ब्रेक डाउन वोल्टेज रीजन. सो दैट्स वाई दिस रीजन इज कॉल्ड एज रिवर्स बायस. इट मीन्स दैट अवर करंट इज नॉट फ्लोइंग राइट. इफ यू डिक्रीज द वोल्टेज देन ऑटोमेटिकली अवर करंट विल गोज टू डाउन मीन्स दैट इज कॉल्ड एज रिवर्स बायस. सो रिवर्स करंट लीकेज राइट. सो थैंक यू सो मच. आई होप यू लाइक दिस लेक्चर. थैंक यू सो मच अगेन.